Alright guys, well this video is primarily about oil change number two, okay? So I get my oil change kits from Deutsch Auto, I'd say my number one Volkswagen sponsor on this channel. And I like his all-in-one sets here because you also get your new plug just for extra safety thrown in the package deal. And I keep it simple. I go with the original sort of OEM oil type stuff, I guess. I don't quote Lubrimoly or any of those fancy brands. I want the original. So we'll talk about timelines here, and I'll look through see when my first oil change was done, which is right there. I personally just write this crap down because it's confusing. So December, gee, that's not too long ago, 4 months ago. At 4,800 miles, same exact oil as you can see, 5W40. Let me make sure. Yeah, same oil. And so let's see, the previous was 4,867. Now it is 8,681. That's actually very close. That's, just about 4,000 miles, if I'm calculating right. Yeah, that's 4,000 miles. Some people say 5,000 miles is plenty on this car, but you know, I'm always one step ahead. If everybody thinks 5,000 is the best, I want to do 4,000. As you know, I drive my car hard. It's hot around here. I drive it aggressively. So, you know, now I'm not going to do 3,000 mile or get super silly like that. But 4,000, I'll make a compromise. So I'm changing the oil 4,000 miles later. Oh, you know, most people mangle the plug and stuff by not using just the right screwdriver for it and all that, and they twist it all up. I haven't even had a chance to use my special tool I also got from DAP Auto last time. Or I got it after oil change number one, realizing how it's hard to not screw that plug getting it out. So now I have the perfect plug with a perfect keyhole type thing to easily remove the plastic with a 90 degree twist, super sweet. So I'm gonna finally enjoy this tool. Whoa, look at that. Right there. Let's go ahead and, can I get this on screen? Yeah. Oh, nice, it goes deep. Okay, it goes deep in. And it doesn't go sideways like I thought. It kind of goes horizontal, and I don't know if the keyhole really makes, yeah, I think it does. Super sweet. Anyway, I have a really cool tool there to ensure that nothing strips. It's the perfect width, you know, a screwdriver blade is not. So just think about that if you're saying, should I waste the money on a tool? And if you search for the tool on DAP Auto, you'll probably find it somewhere, probably in the oil change maintenance section actually. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the car around. I want it facing in. It's hot. It's been sitting a while, but it's a hot day. It's gonna be probably burning all day. It's cooled down a little bit, so I think it'll at least drain very well like this, you know. And I don't like the oil extractors, but a lot of people do use those, so that's another option. If you just don't even want to lay on the ground, you could do the oil extractor. I never feel that it gets everything out properly, but a lot of people do use it. And one thing I should probably spill the beans on, do I got any proof in here? Unfortunately, I probably do. Yeah, I always try and say I'm not OCD anymore, but I guess I am. There was a couple tiny dots and flaws on my carbon fiber, so yes, it was removed. And this was, I think it was only yesterday or something. I guess it's kind of a personal problem. Every time I got in the car, I would study every edge and try and find a reason to take it off. Not because I wanted to, but to see if there's a flaw there, then I don't like it. So I would look for flaws every day. For a few days, I was pleasantly surprised. I said, I can't believe it's still perfect. And then I just saw little dots and glitches here and there. as it maybe settled in a bit. And I don't just want a little bump in the edge of my trim, you know, personal stuff. I just couldn't have it if it's not perfect, so I had to take it off. That's no secret to anybody that's been on my channel for a long time. If it's not really nice, then I just don't want it on my car. So you know how that's killing me. We have an erect rear end right now. Oh, an update on that real quick. I finally set my appointment to drop the car off to get it fixed. That is next Monday, and that's as soon as they can get me in. So it's going to be a while longer before I can do that. So I'm going to turn around the car. Remember, for the future mods, I may get around to these brake lines over the weekend. I may mess with that because that will have no effect on the body work. Like, I didn't want to put any mods on it that could get touched during the work. Brake lines are not going to get touched during the work. That's a mod I can do anytime I want. Change those. Remember the issue with the WRX doing my steel brake lines, and one of them was tight, and I stripped out the piece that's on the car, not the line, but I rounded out a little bit of the hard pipeline that's built into the car. You can't replace it. So as soon as that happened, I did the other three with super heat right on the screw, loosen everything up, and they all came off like butter. I might be out of juice. So lesson learned, I am not gonna touch these stock screws on the car until I heat those all, get them burning hot. Then a simple crescent should bust them loose easily with no stress at all. Make sure I keep those things minty fresh. So this is the key for brake lines. Make sure you heat anything like that if you're going to be messing with those brake lines. I did have a line wrench, by the way. That did not help. What I find is a small crescent actually works better than a line wrench. I know it sounds weird, but as long as it's heated properly, a small wrench is just so perfect and straight. The line wrench could be okay, but my WRX stripped out with the proper line wrench. So there you go. One more little thing I'll be testing soon. This is an RV water filter, and I've seen on one of the enthusiast sites. And what this will do is it will filter out some of that hard water and the spots you get when you're washing your car. And I don't actually get a lot, but I figure nothing to lose having this. This is about $16-17, and I'll put it over by the faucet on the wall. Although you could attach it to your sprayer itself, which is kind of weird. This is really for drinking water, but it does take care of some irons and metals right here. Others, this takes care of aluminum, chromium, iron, lead, mercury, stuff that you don't want to really have in your water for any reason. But for washing your car, you're going to get less spots, and the heat, if the sun dries it, you get less chance of spotting. So I'll be going ahead and testing out this RV. I mean, I'm not going to like be able to show you results. I'm just going to show you how it works and, you know, connect it up and start using this. Now, if this is on an RV for daily water, you got to change it every 3 months. However, this will be once a week for a few minutes. This is a 1 year filter easily if you're only using it for your car wash. So that's a good value, a full year of extra high quality water for your car to clean it nicely. For that cheap price. All right, I'm starting to go on here. Let me get this car turned around as quick as I can. I don't want to get the engine too hot again. One last thing before I get to the oil change. I have three sets of my special spray here to do my stock tips, which I'm not going to touch that till after all the body work. That is extra important. They might mess with that. They may take off the muffler, etc. I'm definitely not touching that, but I do plan on getting those to a satiny black Porsche Lambo kind of look on my raw tips just for now. Did I tell you? I think I only posted on Facebook. I contacted a custom tip place someone referred me to. They do Porsche tips, Lambo tips, and they could have made me any tip I wanted in black. The problem was it was $350. For two custom tips to slide on here. That's a bit too pricey even for me. I understand they're for supercars, they're super high end, and you're not gonna get them for $80, but I couldn't do it. It's too bad. They could have easily made me a 3.2-inch inner diameter, whatever I wanted, any shade of black I wanted, satin, gloss, flat, and made them any size bigger I wanted. I was going to go quarter-inch bigger, tiny bit bigger. It would have been awesome, but hey, I'm not spending $350 on tips. One other tool I got for the oil changes that I forgot to mention. The filter housing is a 32 millimeter socket. I just bought the simple thing right on Amazon. I'll go ahead and link this right up. The Tecton, I like it. Impact and 32 inch. I was using pliers and stuff. You're gonna just bung it all up. So get a nice 32 inch socket if you don't have one already. Make your oil changes that much easier. All right, guys, I got you a little light to show you that sweet T-handle there. Let me see if I can somehow get you an angle with all my hands taken up. So I just turn it counterclockwise, make sure it's here in case it pops out. Oh man, I'm gonna have to let go and it's gonna spew. I think it's lined up good. Come on, baby, here it comes. Oh, all right, that's all right. Oh, I thought the plug would come out with it. That's fine. I mean, safer. I'm not in a big hurry. Yes, I could just pop it out right now, but it'll shoot out and splash everywhere. Now, that being said, this will take a long, long time to drain. I will probably freaking move it and take it out, but that doesn't need to be on camera. It's going to be messy. It actually wasn't very messy at all. It came out slowly. It's a nice design. I do plan to someday upgrade it to metal oil pan, but I'm not lowered. And most of the people with the issues are lowered, and they have a much greater chance. Now, I have heard it occasionally happening to someone on a stock height car, but you know, chances are pretty dang low unless you're being crazy. So I'm just gonna come back in a bit when this drains, get the plug in. Now that the pressure is released underneath, I'll work on getting that new filter in place right there. Well, that's a nice picture. I got the sun right on me right now. That's beautiful right there. All right, guys, I'll see you in a little bit. Now, there is a newer, which I have, a newer type of plunger type stuff here. So when I take this off, this actually stays in there, which is fine, which is good. And you can see that I have this one here where I'm going to bottom out my filter on it. So what I'll do is I'll place the filter in, and I already have my new O-ring. You can see right there. Put it in, and then you push the extra bit right there, quarter inch, half inch, to make sure it's seated, and then you're gonna get a good screw when you put it in. And again, this type, you cannot fill this thing up and turn it like that. And see, it doesn't fall because it's pushed into place real nice, see? Let me make sure on that, my finger, and it's not gonna fall out, so you keep a really nice angle on that as you gently screw it in, like a gorgeous little baby. See if I can get it. I had to push down a little to get past a certain point. I had to make sure that my oil seal was correct. I got nervous. So let me pull it out again, and I'll just go ahead with it. The oil seal does go in the middle. There is nowhere for it to go on the tip down there. I would not use a wrench to tighten this for sure. Don't do it, guys. So if it doesn't turn nicely with your hand, at least almost, you know, almost all the way, stop. Don't force it. Because the first time I turned, it totally stopped at the top. It wasn't threaded right. So it should be easy, you know. You just keep turning it till it stops. Someone's sharing music. It stopped like 100% right there. Can I get a good light on that? Not really, the sun's in my eyes. The sun's in your eyes. It stopped right there, super solid, like 100%. Like, it would be silly to take a wrench to this and keep going. It is done. There's no way this should be tighter. I'm going to break an OCD rule, and I'm not going to take a wrench to it as much as I feel like I should, I want to. I'm not going to do anything else to it. That is completely bottomed out like it should be. Completely bottomed out and tight. So I'm going to leave it like that. So one more trick I do on the oil change. I don't jack it up in the air. I don't put it on jack stands. Don't need to do any of that. I lifted a little bit with the jack, but you can see the tire's still touching, right? That's just enough so I can get my hand under it, okay? But, you know, it's probably not exactly straight and gonna finish dripping properly. So now I'm gonna lower the jack, let it drip a lot. And what that does is when I'm ready to, when I can jack it up a little to put the plug back in, you're definitely not gonna have any drips because, you know, you're draining it at a lower point really fast. You lift it back up, it's just gonna stop the drip. It's always annoying when you're trying to put in your plug. That drip there is the air conditioning stuff, so don't worry about all that. All right, so I'm just gonna lower the jack, get a few more drips out of it, and then put it up and do final tightening, then put in my oil. So one thing on the tool, it stops 100% and clicks into place. Do not keep going after that, no matter what you do. It's tight. It doesn't feel like it. It isn't like a traditional bolt where you're gonna torque it to 13, 14 foot pound. This thing just, it turns and you feel a notch and it moves and clicks into place and that's it. So it looked, I'd assume every car is the same. It looks like your handle is horizontal when it's done. And I just turned maybe one full turn, maybe even less, and it just clicked into place. And we can look right here. I can't even see it, but just so I can see it later, that's how it ends up. So I'm ready to start filling this thing and get going on it. All right, guys, before I put in my last quart, just to show you, the one tool I don't have for the perfect VW oil change is the big screw-in funnel that screws into the oil cap threads itself. Because, I guess I'll take it out. You don't have any hole in there. There's big brackets in the way. So no funnel you have is gonna fit in there nice and deep. So you're always at a risk of it falling. So for now, I just tie wrap this for extra safety if it falls. And I kind of gently put it in there. See, it only goes in an eighth of an inch. But I pour slowly. I don't hit the funnel with my bottle. And I usually keep a hand on it. But that's the one piece I could use. And I think those are expensive, like 30 bucks for a funnel or something. But I could see why it's really good, because that's just a pain in the butt. Be careful shoving funnels in there too. On my Mark 6 once, I shoved the funnel in too hard. I broke off, I unsnapped the metal, just a bracket, a shield, off of its clips in there. And somehow, the hole was bigger on the Mark 6s, the oil hole for sure. Because I somehow got my fingers in there and snapped it back into place. I have no idea. It took me probably a half hour. But that's an extra tip. Don't just shove it in a funnel in there through that little crack where they can see a hole and push, because it might catch that bracket and pull it off. And then it's in your valves. You're in big trouble. So just a tip there too. Be very careful filling that oil in that oil funnel and the hole. All right, guys. Starting to feel a little sick. It's hot out here. I've been working. Last clip, I want to show you the dipstick where we ended up, okay? And this is exactly 6 quarts, everything that came in the kit. And I'm contemplating ordering another one, putting in a little more. And I'll show you where I'm at with 6 quarts. I did start the car, run it for a couple of minutes, and I'll bring the camera over in the light. I don't care if it drips. So, and one more look, exactly half the crosshatch, 6 quarts.